Is also standing by there with Sanjay. And I know, Anderson, you've been following a very disturbing story. And I just want to warn people, especially if you have any kids in the room with you right now, the video that Anderson has is pretty tough to watch. And I know, Anderson, you visited an area that simply became a mass grave after the earthquake. Tell us what you found today.
Well, we've been on the trail of missing Americans, 4,500 to 5,000, according to the U.S. government here, no exact number. We wanted to find out what is happening to the people who have simply disappeared, whose bodies were dumped into trucks and taken off. We had gone to a mass grave about 2 weeks ago, right after the earthquake, and obviously it was a horrific sight. We thought 2 weeks later that it would at least be covered over, some sort of order would be there. What we were stunned to discover is that many of the bodies, many of the dead have simply been left dumped on the ground. And we're talking about 2 weeks later. Today we tried to track down government officials to find out who's responsible for this and why they can't have simple decency to bury these people. I mean, there's pits that are open, but literally they have just left in the location we were at, you know, more than a dozen or two dozen bodies just in horrendous piles out on the ground. I can't even really describe to you the scenes that we saw, and we're trying to be very judicious in the pictures that we are showing you. There's absolutely no reason for this. They took the trouble to use a bulldozer to block the access road to prevent people from going into the site, so clearly they don't want anybody to know about it. The government spokesperson I talked to today said, first of all, didn't seem to believe me when I was telling her that we had seen this with our own eyes, and then said she would try to find out, you know, why this was the case, and that's certainly not government policy to do that. But it's incredibly disturbing for not only the Americans' families of the missing, but for Haitians who, you know, they don't know where their loved ones are, but they certainly don't want their loved ones to end up just dumped on the side of a road.
No kidding. I mean, you can't imagine how frustrating this has to be for the families. Anderson Cooper, who we should say will have much more on this and other aspects of the story tonight on 360, and Sanjay Gupta, who joined us there as well, appreciate it.